six five-minute rounds, one fall, one submission or a knockout to the winner. Thank you. Your referee, Max Wall.
So our second solo bout here this afternoon, with Barnes having won the first one over Chris Adams. Clive Myers, Iron Fist there on the right, the band round his head, Iron Fist written on it. He's going to have something to do against the very much heavier Soul Brother Bond here.
First round.
So Myers, as always, giving away about 4 stone plus here to the big man from Deptford. Remember, again a 6 5-minute round contest, one fall decides it. Let's see if Iron Fist can level things up again in the 1 hour here before the tag. Similar sort of idea about here, I should think, because Bond must get in close with his strength, always use his extra weight. His great advantage here, because if he allows Iron Fist any room at all for the ring, he's going to be in real trouble from arms and feet. The world middleweight arm wrestling champion, remember. Solitary applause coming from ringside started that, with Bobby Barnes clapping Death Bond, his partner. So Phil Nelson released by Bond himself. Iron Fist hasn't really started yet. Now he's going, now he's away. And that's the sort of thing we were meaning just now when we said we must not give Iron Fist any room in this ring. He must stay in close, like that. The second one is going on the deck. I would say. And just at the moment is very much on the canvas, but how long? Certainly, Myers, Iron Fist Myers, having a little trouble with this early part of this round. Allowing Bond in far too near with his strength holds. But that's possible reason why he was. But he's still got him in a double leg, Nelson. Trying to reach for a crutch hold, and neither of them make it. Very close to a clenched fist there, but the referee quite happy with the spot. Just a minute left in this first round of six. Remember, one fall decides it. A happy start for Iron Fist Myers. In an arm lock now, but this is his way out. Ooh, ooh. What a neat way out of an armlock. Very seldom see that. Barnes giving a little advice to his partner, Bond. Bobby Barnes outside the ring on the floor there. Probably keep away from him unless you've got him close, I should think. That's the best advice Bond could take here.
Wrist lift.
So the arm lever.
No!
Tell me.
No!
Well, the Bond's
no.
Slowing down for a bit here with Bond still getting his man. On the bell to end round one. So, the first round's gone of this second solo bout. In this team contest, the martial arts fighters versus Barnes and Bond, and Barnes seconding his partner Bond. And quite an exciting opening couple of bouts to this first time we've ever been at Elmbridge Leisure Centre here in Walton-on-Thames. A packed crowd here, very much enjoying the wrestling, and I think it's going to warm a little bit more any second if Bond just stays away a little bit longer. He's bound to risk it on some occasions. He can't go in all the time. Round two, five to go. One to four decided. Bond having all his own way at the moment. Using his 4.5 stone weight advantage. So both Barnes and Bond now have had one public warning. But Bond has still quite determination here to continue dictating this bout, as he has from the start, more or less. Oh, right over the top, and a not too good landing right on the back there. He didn't get the feet down that time. But he's here, he comes with a chance. That's what he needs. For a 16 stone Bond right over there, no trouble at all.
Three, four.
Just hoping that Bond was going to follow up there, but he didn't. Those feet coming to action now with those mule kicks. Very strong. Still Bond doing the majority of the attacking. At the moment, unfairly. On the ropes. This is a tremendous advantage here. Yes, holding, waiting for him in the cave. Again. Will be with this man with those backdrops, so that's one and only. He's going to get back before 10 now. He's still got counted. 3, 4, 5. And now here comes Armfist, back into the third. The time they try and get an equaliser. His partner was beaten in the first solo bout, and now he's got to equalize for his team. No. 2 minutes to go in the second. Stretch, feet in the shoulders. And surprise, surprise.
Is that man resting or doing crossroads?
And he's certainly got Bond a little worried now. He's keeping his distance all right, but a bit early to... He's only got a minute left in the second round. Has to wait till another couple of rounds ago, I should think. That time he has slowed him and weakened him a bit. No amount of advice from Bobby Barnes there can really help him as long as he doesn't get in close with the strength holes. And now he's trying it again. So Bobby's must have said that. And now he's got that headband of Iron Fist down over his eyes. That's why he's making sure the referee doesn't spot him. And still over the eyes. Iron Fist, no idea where he is at the moment. If the bell goes to end round two. First down in the center of the ring there, struggling to get that headband of his up to the forehead again. There it is, helped by Chris Adams, his partner. So Iron Fist with two rounds gone, he's still got four, but a very slow start for him. Round three, four to go. One fall decides this bout, the second of the solo bouts. Martial arts fighters versus Barnes and Bond. This one is Iron Fist, Clive Myers versus Dave Soulbrother Bond. And Bond has one public warning against him. What do you want him to do? Yeah. Bond really fell for that. Straight fingers off the throat. His partner outside the ring there, screaming for more of that. Glad to see Iron Fist really go for the first time. Suddenly remembering he had one public warning against him before he'd needed it. That's the most free will of tremendous. It's knocking him out on both men on the other deck. Myers getting on top of the legs there, but he won't do any good outside the ring anyway. It's just a question of that they're both tied it out on. They are. Even that's not made it. And I think we'll find that the MC will announce the fact that it was a double knockout, neither man making the count in that third.
Ladies and gentlemen, Max Walt's decision. Both wrestlers unable to beat the count. Ladies and gentlemen, the referee's verdict stands. It's a double knockout.